Every odd number can be written as the difference of two squares.
And naturally, you're going to show this algebraically. So let's take an odd number. Let's take 2n plus 1. That's how you write odd numbers. And, well, this is going to be a bit cheaty, but I'm going to add n squared and subtract n squared. Now, let me just rearrange those terms a little bit. So it's n squared plus 2n plus 1 minus n squared. Now, those first three terms, I can factorize into n plus 1 squared minus n squared. So hey, I've shown that every odd number is the difference of two squares.
And naturally, the best way to show that is graphically. So an odd number is one single unit and then pairs. Those pairs can be split into two lines of equal length, which gives us a kind of right angled L. But hang on, that missing bit, that's a square. And we can move that square out of the way to reveal another square. When we put them together, it's one square, subtract the other. Every odd number is the difference of two squares. And we can demonstrate that graphically. It's the best way to do it. Although some people are likely to say,
oh, that's fine and all, it looks pretty in there, but all you're saying is that every square number is the sum of consecutive odd numbers.
And they're kind of right. So there's a nice related fact where if you start with one, the first odd number, and the first square number, and then bring in three, the next odd number, you get four, the next square number. In comes five, and you get nine. Once seven shows up, we end up with 16. And you can see how this carries on. It's a nice graphical proof that if you add all the consecutive odd numbers, you get all of the square numbers.
Yeah, you could do it that way, but that's not the way Gauss would have done it. He would have done it algebraically. So let's do it in a Gauss style. What I'm going to do is imagine I'm going to add up all the odd integers and they end with the integer, let's say 2n minus 1. Let's do it, let it be 2n minus 1 this time. Then let's add them in pairs. Let's take the first term and the last term and let's add them together, you get 2n. Let's take the second term and the second to last term, add them together, you get 2n again. So we're going to add them in pairs that way. And how many pairs do we have? We actually have 2n over 4 pairs. So 2n multiplied by 2n over 4 pairs is n squared, which is exactly what I wanted.
The question now is, if all the odd numbers can be written as the difference of two squares, what other numbers can also be written as the difference of two squares? Does it work for any of the evens? And we're going to try it graphically. Let's do this. So, if we start with a similar diagram to the original one, where we've got square A subtract square B, the length of that little bonus bit is A minus B. We can move that around to the side, and the other length is A plus B. So this graphically shows that A squared subtract B squared equals A plus B times A subtract B. We can now investigate what values we can get from that by looking at odds and evens. So A can be odd or even, B can be odd or even. I'm using a lone unit plus a pair to represent an odd and just a pair to represent an even. In both these cases, you could add or remove any extra pairs. So this works for any odds or any evens. Now we need a plus B and a subtract B. So that's two grids. We can fill in every single value. And if we highlight all the evens, you can see they're in the same position in both grids. And all the odds are in the same positions. This means if A plus B is odd, A subtract B must be odd. If A plus B is even, A subtract B is even. They're always the same. So we've managed to show that the difference of two squares will never give you a number which can only be written as an odd times an even. Yes, I mean, it's just that simple.
It sounds like you've got yourself into a bit of a mess there, Matt. I think what you need is a little bit more mathematical power. I think you need the power of modular arithmetic, which just means we're looking at the remainders after division by four. Every number has a remainder of either 0, 1, 2, or 3, after division by 4. Now, if you look at the square of those numbers, well, the power of modular arithmetic tells us that we just square the remainders, so they're going to have remainders of either 0 or 1. Now, we're looking at the difference of two squares. We just take the difference of the remainders. It's going to be a number with a remainder of either 0 minus 0, 0 minus 1, 1 minus 0, or 1 minus 1, which shows us that the difference of two squares has a remainder of either 0, 1 or 3, What it means is the difference of two squares never has a remainder of two after division by four. It means you're not going to get numbers like 2, 6, 10, 14. They can't be the difference of two squares. Hi, Matt.
They're the numbers which are an odd times an even.
I guess so, yeah. Well, let's see. We got 2, 6, 10, 14. They would be.
Yeah, I feel like that's... We did the same thing.
I think I did it better.
That is debatable. So I kind of get that mod 1 and 3.
Yes.
They're all the odds.
Those are all the odd numbers which we know can be a difference of two squares. We've shown that already.
Done. And you've managed to rule out all the ones which are mod 2.
Yep.
Just
they
like I did.
Can't be done.
Now, mod 0,
yep.
Multiples of 4.
Yep.
You've shown that they can't not be done.
Right.
But we haven't shown that all multiples of 4 are the difference of two squares.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, Matt, I'm going to prove it with algebra. All right. So what are we going to do? Right, multiples of 4, which we'll write as 4k. That's how you write multiples of 4.
Yeah, I can see that.
Now I'm going to factorize this into two different even numbers. So why not factorize it into 2 and 2k?
All right. Oh, yeah, because all multiples of 4 are 2 times an even number.
I think that's perfectly fair.
And if one's bigger than the other,
yeah,
we can show that the midpoint must be an integer.
Yeah,
because they're both
true.
Even.
That's fine.
And so the smaller one, 2, is the midpoint, the average,
yep.
Subtract half the difference.
Exactly.
And the bigger one is the midpoint plus half the difference.
Perfect. Now, if we call that midpoint A, we call half the difference B, then what are we showing? Well, 2 is just A minus B, 2k, the other factor, A plus B. Hey, what we got? It's A squared minus B squared.
Difference of two squares.
Difference of two squares.
Okay, thank you so much for watching our video about the difference of two squares. Huge thanks to James for coming along to help me make it. Thank you all my Patreon supporters who make this possible. I mean, James is hugely expensive to get involved in a video.
Well, yeah, that's true, but I am cheaper than Steve Moll.
That is a fact. That's
it's true.
It's true. And we encourage you to be honest, the videos cost nothing. I didn't even have to buy him lunch. So we encourage you to have a go at doing your own investigations into what numbers are the difference of two squares. Don't get me wrong, we feel like we've been very thorough.
I think so, but we have missed one important number.
What was that?
So we haven't talked about the number 4 itself.
Oh, because we assumed that 2K is bigger than 2.
Yeah.
And 4 would just be 2 times 2.
Yeah, so we had an average and we were looking at difference. But yeah, 4 is 2 times 2. There is no difference. The difference would be 0. So that did not account for what we said before.
I don't think I get that with my tech. I mean, 4. Well, hang on, but 4 can only be an odd number times. Well, it was 2 times 2. It can be an even times an even. Huh.
So we're missing something.
So 4 can't be the difference of two squares.
Well, I think it can. I think 4 is 2 squared minus 0 squared.
No, 0 is not a square. I will accept 1 is a square number. I will not accept that 0 is a
square. 0 is a square number.
It's not even a trivial square number. It's just...
It's 0 is a number. It's a proper number. It's an even number.
Don't start that. Oh my. No, I will... Okay. I refuse to accept that zero, because otherwise you could say every single square number is the difference of two squares because it's itself.
Fine.
No, that doesn't work.
I see no problem with that whatsoever.
But I guess every other square number is either odd, so we've already got it,
uh-huh.
Or it's got two twos, so it's a multiple of 4.
Therefore, we've already accounted it for everything except and including 4 itself. Thank you very much.
I'm not taking it. You'll accept it. I will not accept it.
You will accept it.
No, that, everybody, is the difference of two squares.